أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers and sisters, my brothers and sisters, a very important topic, a very important reminder for myself and for everyone out there. And this topic is, are we behaving like Shaytan or do we have the behavior of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Now, my brothers and sisters, unfortunately, as you can see, the time that we're living in, things are getting worse. They're not getting better. And it's these times right now, we all, including myself, we all need to pull up. We all need to remember our purpose. We need to remember how we have to live our lifestyle and what is important, deen or dunya. And every day it's a distraction. Every day we get distracted, we get tempted. Shaytan comes and he whispers in our ears. And unfortunately now, the behavior of a Muslim is like, he's acting and he's behaving, he or she are acting and behaving like the Shaytan. They're not behaving as a humble Muslim. Nowadays, if I call someone, I have to call him 100 times and send him 100 text messages just to get him to call me back or to respond back. Because the mentality now is, if I don't answer my call straight away, I have to make him wait. I have to make he or she wait. If he sends me a text message, even though the phone's in his hand, or he or she's phone's in his hand, I take half an hour to respond. Because we have this disease, my brothers and sisters, and it's called takabbur. We think we're better than each other, and we compete. And I'm going to be speaking haq here, something that a lot of people don't want to admit. We compete with one another, and we have this disease in our heart where we think I'm better than him, or I'm more important than him, and we belittle our brothers and sisters. I had a youngster tell me, brother, you are so humble. Yani, the way you talk to me is like the people in my age group, the way they talk to me. But you're bigger, you're older than me. A lot of brothers your size, this is what he told me, because a lot of brothers your size and your age, they belittle me. They look down on me. My brothers and sisters, this behavior is from Shaytan. And there's a lot of people that don't want to admit this because they have arrogance in their heart. But unfortunately, a lot of us have this characteristic where if we think I'm bigger, I'm better, I have more money, I have more wealth, I have more children, we start belittling one another. I have so many times, it doesn't matter how old the person is, who he is, how small he is, how old they are, we have to respect one another. And we have to get rid of this takabbur in our hearts, because this is the behavior of the Shaytan. Shaytan, when Allah said to Shaytan, prosper to Adam, he circled him, he looked at him up and down. He had takabbur in his heart. Takabbur means in a sense where I'm better than him. You made me from fire and him from clay. And he refused because he had this takabbur. And unfortunately today, the same thing applies with our brothers and sisters. I have brothers tell me, hey, the girl is up herself. Shayfa Hala, she thinks she's, you know, she's better than me. We have to get rid of this arrogance. This is the behavior of the Shaytan. This is not the behavior of a Muslim. A Muslim is humble. A Muslim, a real believer, wants for what he wants for himself, he wants it for his brothers and his sisters. That's a real believer. But a person that's living a lifestyle of Shaytan, the person that's behaving like Shaytan, his characteristics is going to be jealousy, he's going to be envious, he's going to be, I need to be better than him, he's going to be competing and backbiting. It just, the list keeps going on. But a real Muslim, a real believer, a real mu'min, what I want for me, I want for my brothers and sisters. If I have something nice, I want it for my brothers and sisters. Not, I'm jealous, I start backbiting, I start belittling, I start looking down on him, I start speaking with him because I'm older or bigger or younger than him. We have to treat each other like brothers and sisters. And this reminder is also for myself. I'm humble enough, I've fallen into these mistakes many times. We need to be humble. When you're humble, you can change. But when you're arrogant and you think, you know what, I don't do nothing wrong and I'm perfect and everything's good with me, but it's everyone else's problem, you've got a disease, my brother or sister. You have a disease. We need to be humble. We need to treat our brothers and sisters with respect. The way you want to be treated, treat them that way. If they have the problem, that's their problem. But do it for the sake of Allah. Because once you start acting like them, once you start having that behavior of the shaitan like them, you've become them. They've won. Even if you're good to someone and they treat you badly, and you say, you know what, the reason why I am the way I am today is because when I do good, people treat me badly. Once you become like them due to that fact, you've become like them. Khalas, you've lost. They beat you because they've broken you. They've made you become just like them. Keep that characteristic. Be good. Follow our Prophet Muhammad's teaching. Treat people good, even when they treat you bad, and your heart will remain pure. You're doing this for the sake of Allah. Don't let people break you, my brothers and sisters. Don't treat people bad. Don't think I'm better. Don't be on a high horse with people. Treat everyone equally. Do it for the sake of Allah. Do it for your own sake, because how you treat people will come back to you. My brothers and sisters, please stay humble. Please follow our teachings of the Prophet Muhammad. Please don't belittle anyone. Don't think you're better than anyone. Don't think I'm more important. I got more than anyone. Don't compete with everyone. My brothers and sisters, a real believer, what he wants for himself, he wants for his brothers and sisters. Please, my brothers and sisters, be right Muslims. Follow the deen properly. And don't forget your purpose. We're here to worship Allah. We're not here to compete with one another. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to guide us all to the straight path, to keep us humble, to get rid of this shaitan characteristic, and to forgive us all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.